गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन। नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू विद लेसन 13, ग्रीन एंड क्लीन अर्थ। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन एयर एंड वाटर पोल्यूशन इन द प्रीवियस क्लास। सो टुडे वी बिगिन विद द रीडिंग ऑफ सॉइल पोल्यूशन। द प्रेजेंस ऑफ हार्मफुल सब्सटेंसेज इन द सॉइल इज कॉल्ड सॉइल पोल्यूशन। वॉट एवर हार्मफुल सब्सटेंसेज आर एडेड नोइंगली और अनोइंगली टू द सॉइल दे कॉज सॉइल पोल्यूशन। नाउ वी विल रीड अबाउट द कॉजेज। People throw solid waste such as plastics, glasses, metals, animal waste, plant waste into the soil. So all these waste they cause soil pollution by mixing into the soil, and it decreases the fertility of the soil when all these waste are thrown into the soil. They also throw agricultural waste like when the crop is harvested. उसके बाद जो उसका भूसा होता है, ये सब चीजें जो waste होता है, plants होते हैं after taking out the fruits and all, so they are also thrown on the land. That also causes soil pollution, like animal dung, plant waste, dead animals, fertilizers and pesticides. Whichever this agricultural waste is added into the soil, then it causes soil pollution. Then toxic chemicals produced in the factories, industries are thrown on fallow land. Fallow land means empty plot or any empty land which is found near the factories or industries. They throw all the toxic chemicals there which is produced in the factories. So now the effects of the soil pollution is that non-biodegradable waste like polythene and plastic do not allow the soil to breathe. You all know that roots of the plants have to breathe, so there is air inside the soil also, because soil particles are there is a little distance between or gap between the soil particles and the air is filled there. So the roots have the space to grow down because of this air. But due to non-biodegradable waste like polythene and plastic, the soil is not able to breathe and the plants also cannot grow properly in this kind of soil. The chemical waste from factories when thrown into the soil makes it toxic or poisonous. Toxic means poisonous. Plants cannot grow well on polluted soil. So that is why it is very important to stop the pollution of soil. Now we will read the prevention or the measures we can take to prevent soil pollution. We must throw garbage in separate garbage bins, wet garbage in one bin and dry garbage in the another bin. Then authorities must dump wet garbage into decomposing pits to convert them into manure. You all know that compost pits are made. पिट मतलब होता है गड्ढा। कंपोस्ट पिट्स आर मेड टू मेक कंपोस्ट एंड द वेट गार्बेज लाइक पील्स ऑफ वेजिटेबल्स एंड सच काइंड ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल व्हिच कम्स फ्रॉम द प्लांट्स कैन बी पुट इनटू दैट डिकम्पोजिंग पिट एंड द मैन्योर कैन बी फॉर्मड विद दैट। एंड ड्राई गार्बेज मस्ट बी रिसाइकल्ड टू मेक यूजेबल थिंग्स व्हिच कैन बी यूज्ड अगेन। वी मस्ट डिस्पोज ऑफ पॉलिथिन बैग्स एंड प्लास्टिक्स प्रॉपरली। पॉलिथिन बैग्स एंड प्लास्टिक्स choke drains, so the sewage also gets choked because of these plastic and polythenes. As a result, they pollute the air by giving out foul smell. We must say no to poly bags. We must never use polythene bags. We must carry the jute bags or the cloth bags. Now biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste, we will read about them. Solid waste can be classified into biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. Biodegradable waste are those which can be decomposed or rotted. Rotted matlab sadna, decomposed matlab bhi sadna hota hai. So when the things which can be decomposed or rotted, they are called biodegradable. Examples of some biodegradable waste include all plant and animal products like fruit and vegetable peels, wood, paper, animal dung, dead plant and animal parts. These waste can be used to make manures by burying them in compost pit. This already you know that compost pit mein ye sab dalne se manure ya compost ban jati hai, so they can be used again and they are biodegradable. Matlab wo sad sakte hain, decompose ho sakte hain. You can see the some examples given over here: old newspapers, vegetable peels, wood and dead rat. All these are biodegradable waste. Now we will read about non-biodegradable waste. Are those which cannot be decomposed or rotted. जो सड़ नहीं सकते, गल नहीं सकते, millions of years तक वो ऐसे के ऐसे ही रहते हैं. They are called by non-biodegradable waste. Examples of such waste include glass, plastics, metals, detergents and synthetic rubber. Plastics and metals can be recycled many times for reuse. So these two can be reused and so that they do not cause soil pollution. But other detergents and glass, all these are this detergents are chemicals which pollute the soil forever, and glass is also non-biodegradable waste. So some examples are here: glass bottles, plastic chairs, computer parts and polythene bags. Now we will read about four important things. Four R's: reuse, recycle, reduce and refuse. Now these are very, very important to reduce the pollution. The four R's that we must practice to reduce pollution are reuse, recycle, reduce and refuse. Now reuse matlab you have to use it again. Reuse means use a thing again which we throw. For example, an empty biscuit tin can be reused for storing materials like sugar and dal. Instead of throwing old clothes and shoes into garbage, we can give them to people who are needy or poor. So this is a reuse, not only to needy and poor, but also sometimes you can also wear your elder sisters and brothers clothes to reuse them. Okay, if they are not spoiled or they are in good, very good condition, so you should not throw them, you should use them again, wear them and use them again. Then recycle: plastic, polythene bags, glass bottles and paper can be recycled by melting and molding them into new useful things. So they can be melted in the factories and then they can be used to make something else. Then reduce: we must buy things in the amounts we need. We should never buy unnecessary things. Only according to our requirement we should do the shopping. When we buy anything in excess, it produces waste. So we must use public transport instead of taking personal vehicles. It will not only reduce the consumption of petrol or diesel, but also produce less air pollution. At the same time, we can save money. So this is also important, that we should go to school or any other place by public transport or vans. You can pool in the cars and then you can go. So reducing the air pollution by using one vehicle for many people. Then refuse: do not accept things that pollute the environment. Say no to poly bags. So when you go for shopping, you should take the jute bag or your cloth bag, and you should tell to vegetable vendors and others that please don't give me polythene bags. I will take it in my jute bag or a cloth bag. So do not accept polythene bags from shopkeepers. Either ask them to give you a paper bag or you carry a cloth or jute bag from home when you go for shopping. Thus, each individual can play a very important role in conserving and protecting our environment. We have to do our bit for a cleaner and greener world. We have to spread the awareness of threats to the environment which are due to our careless attitude and activities. So this, all these things which you have read today, please try to implement them in your daily life and try to reduce the pollution. Okay, that's all in this chapter, children. Please do the reading. Questions can come from between the chapters also. And see you in the next class. Then we will do exercises. Okay.